No matter what journey you're on in life, it's very easy to be deafened by the noise of the world.
If the world is ever going to become a better place, it's going to come from the arts. We literally had no idea what a wonderful thing this was going to become.
My name is Rebecca Jackson, and I started music in May in 2008. I grew up in Santa Cruz, and I knew I wanted to bring back a little part of what I'm passionate about, what I believe in, chamber music, and I wanted to make an imprint on my hometown. A little over a year ago, I was in Beirut, Lebanon, and I had a literal demonstration of the power of music and its ability to unite people of all backgrounds. We were in the camp and we were told by the American filmmaker that took us in that it was the first time in his 1 year of working in the camps that the Bangladeshi, Palestinian, and Syrian refugees stood together. That is the power of music. Most people know Music in May for the main stage concerts that we perform. But really, the heart of this festival are the musicians going into the community, connecting with our kids, especially the underserved.
So who wants to volunteer what they were imagining?
Yes.
My biggest impression is that the kids are so engaged, and then I can see them just so excited and feeling inspired for maybe that's something they could do in their lives.
I like about music because it calms my body.
Life makes you feel like being so like not alone.
And it kind of feels great to kind of express yourself with music.
What we have been seeing is that music really brings a community together.
Also, another new relationship I've built and I'm excited to take more musicians to the special needs class at Brook Noel Elementary.
A lot of the time with disability, you feel isolated and you feel excluded because you can't always go to the places other people go to.
I'm really excited about the way the whole project has grown and how it's taken hold in the community and the impact that it's having here in Santa Cruz.
In 2014, we began our partnership and going in regularly to the Santa Cruz County Juvenile Hall.
We do a lot here in our Santa Cruz County Juvenile Hall. Despite the programs and the volunteers that come in, youth are stuck in white cylinder brick walls all day long.
Oftentimes I feel like my kids are unseen by the community, or people make assumptions, negative assumptions about who they are.
It is so special to take these phenomenal musicians into the juvenile detention center.
Going to a place like that really does bring out for me the magic of what it means to make music.
One of the most rewarding things is watching what happens to the faces of the kids as this music is being played.
And even the staff were surprised. They really liked this dorky classical music.
It's kind of weird, isn't it? It like calms me down. I don't know, I can't really explain it, but it's like, makes you feel good, you know?
I'll just remember like the sound of the music and how beautiful it was.
We kind of all forget where we are and it grounds and it levels everybody. So no longer are we staff and youth. It unifies everybody and it's something that bonds and connects everyone.
Music in May, they are having an impact on a part of the community that most of us ignore.
So to have something as beautiful as music come in allows the youth an escape. They do, for that moment, are set free.
Music in May has grown from a kitchen table project to a full-fledged 501c3 organization. And it's time now that this little bird spreads its wings and flies.
I love Music in May because, well, I get to play with my friends.
Music is a part of everybody's life. It brings people together.
Music for me is a guide to help us feel the things that we ought to feel. I'm not gonna put up any walls now. For me, that's the essence of what music is really about.
And the more that I go into communities that normally I wouldn't associate with, what I realized was we're all humans. We all want love. We all want to belong.
The song has always been there. The theme has always been love and life. And music is, in every phrase that we make, a celebration of that.
Anyone who's been to Music in May in the last 10 years know of David Arvin, my dear mentor who passed away recently. He was the only one to survive the Holocaust in his family, and it was because of the violin. One of my favorite quotes by him, "Music is life, music is hope, music is peace. I cannot ask for more."